Lucius, it's Bruce. He's not here. Damn it. I'm going to search for clues.
Just tell me how I can help.
Get over here as fast as you can.
I'm on my way. We're gonna find him, Bruce.
I know. Need to focus. Figure out what happened here. What happened to you, Al? Ash everywhere. What did they do to you, Alfred? Something big was thrown against this wall. Or someone. Furniture scattered outwards from a single point. How the hell? Face was knocked over in the struggle. The fight left nothing untouched. This pool cue was used as a weapon. Swung so hard it broke in half. Blood pattern looks like it came off a high velocity hit. A scuff mark. What could have caused this? Alfred used the pool cue as a weapon, broke it across his attacker's head. When that didn't stop him, he used the jagged end to stab, spraying blood across the pool table. The lock's been completely destroyed. Alfred must have barricaded himself in here. But they got in anyway. Alfred grabbed the fireplace poker to fend off an attacker. But it was knocked away. Lady Arkham must have used the concussion blast from her staff to try and stop Alfred. I know what happened. The children of Arkham broke in. Alfred barricaded himself inside the parlor. He had just enough time to grab a pool cue as a weapon before Lady Arkham blasted the doors open. He broke it across one of their heads, then stabbed him to get away. Another assailant tackled Alfred, knocking over the vase. Alfred almost escaped, but then Lady Arkham entered the parlor. Used her staff's concussion blast, scattering all the furniture in her path. throwing him against the wall by the fireplace. So Alfred grabs the nearest thing to use as a weapon to defend himself. But Lady Arkham deflected Alfred's attack, causing the poker to fly across the room and lodge into the wall. More blood on the mantle. He smashed his face into it. Wait. That picture doesn't belong there. Lady Arkham wanted me to find this. Alfred. The butler did it. Password reckoning. You have no idea.
What she's doing to him.
All right. Well, then let's get to work.
Alfred keeps adjusting his glasses. The reflection. He's making sure I see the reflection in his glasses. He knows the Bat Computer can use multiple reflection angles to recreate the room that he's in. And I can view the virtual image using my cowl.
Good thinking, Alfred.
Okay, Lucius. Freeze frame on the first signal Alfred gives.
Paint us a picture. Here we go.
Stairs leading up. Cement walls. We're in a basement. Alfred's trying to look at things that might give us a clue to where he's being held. Professional-grade camera. Probably came from the Gazette's office. He's wounded.
Must be one of the thugs Alfred fought upstairs.
Okay, looks like we've seen all there is to see in this frame. Let's move on to Alfred's next signal.
You got it.
Doesn't seem to be anything else here.
Let's keep looking.
Rogers Plumbing. A service company for the water heater. I can use their records to find home addresses for their clients.
We're getting closer.
Yeah, but we're not there yet. Nothing else to see here.
Moving on.
A Mason stamp.
Only one Masonic lodge in the city. Gotham City Fraternal Order of Stonemasons.
So the house was built in 1945 by them. That's a big lead. Lady Arkham. Keep searching. Jump to Alfred's next signal.
You got it.
A basement window.
What's that outside?
Give me a second. They're by a bus stop.
Here we go.
Okay, I think we have enough to pinpoint a location.
Well, let's hope.
These are all the homes serviced by this water heater company on the days and months listed. I can get the bus line from this, but no stop number. This will help pinpoint the neighborhood. Okay, filtering for all homes built on that date. A corner store. Seems unlikely. Bowling alley. Damn it. Let's keep looking. You are not going to believe this.
What is it?
Lady Arkham is back at the Vale House, where she killed her foster parents. According to its records, it has a basement.
Well, just in case she's expecting you.
What is that?
Something I almost didn't get to finish because of Penguin. It's the most advanced version yet.
Lady Arkham will have no idea what I've got up these sleeves. Well done, Lucius.
You've been long overdue for an upgrade. This suit is beyond state of the art. This ends tonight. Heading into the basement.
Be careful.
I'm all right. There's no one here. No Alfred.
Damn it!
There's blood on the walls. I'm going to see what I can find.
Standing by.
Alfred's blood is still fresh.
Means we can't be far behind them.
This is where they had Alfred. Where they beat him. Alfred. There's a boot print in the blood. Lady Arkham's soldiers dragged him. The trail stops at the wall. Actually, it goes under it.
Sounds like there's more to this basement than it would appear.
Taking a closer look. The wall is just a facade.
Why would the Vales have a false wall in their basement?
Now let's find out what the Vales were hiding. There's a small room. With a hole in the floor. I'm going inside.
Down there. Do you see Alfred?
No. It's some kind of torture chamber. Shackles, belts, blood.
What?
Vicky. She was kept down here. Locked away.
Who could do that to their child?
I'm beginning to understand.
What is there to understand? To willfully hurt a child?
Vicky was just a child.
and the veils locked her in the dark. Beat her. Revenge must seem like the only choice.
Their own daughter!
The Vale's foster children may not have been the only ones to suffer here. I followed Alfred's blood into this hole. If he had any opportunity at all, he would have left me a clue.
Disturbing.
Vicky created her here, in this room. This is where Vicky Vale became Lady Arkham. There are drawings. Vicky must have drawn them when she was a prisoner. The chalk here is different, newer. Bloody scratches, fingernails. Someone tried to climb out.
Alfred?
No. Shackles. Blood on them. Old. And new. Vicky did to Alfred what was done to her. The belt. It's caked in blood. Alfred laid down here. Glasses. One piece apart from the others.
Red?
The same color as my tech. Can't be a coincidence. Maybe those towers. That must be Arkham Asylum. This is what he wanted me to find. To see. He spelled it out here. Taking me. And used Vicky's own drawing of Arkham for the location.
Arkham? But people would know. The staff would see them.
That's the final piece. Arkham. She's been using Wayne Enterprises to get access to the buildings with Wayne Tech security systems. Including Arkham Asylum. She's going to open the doors. Release the inmates. And she took Alfred with her. Call Gordon in the GCPD.
I'm on it.
Lady Arkham won't be expecting us. We'll catch her by surprise.
Orderlies are rounded up.
That's the last of it, then.
The children of Arkham have taken over.
That suits no slouch. You're well prepared for a fight. And the GCPD are on their way to deal with the inmates. If you can find Alfred, maybe you can get him out of there before all hell breaks loose.
Almost ready. Let her know.
Copy. On our way. Go ahead. I got this.
Batman.
This ends now, Vicky. Tell me where Alfred Pennyworth is.
The butler.
Bruce Wayne has a bat on his payroll.
Answer the question.
Where he is doesn't matter. He'll be dead soon. Another corpse in Bruce Wayne's family.
No one's dying tonight.
You really think you're in control here? Your confidence is impressive, but that won't save the butler or the rest of Gotham. A lesson needs to be taught. They won't look the other way. Not again.
And when did Gotham look away from you, Victor?
Don't try to psychoanalyze me, Batman. You have no idea what I've done to come this far. Too much to turn back now.
I know you've suffered. You were tortured, held captive by the people who were supposed to love you. I don't know how you survived.
You want to know how I survived? I survived because every night I dreamed of the revenge I'd take on them. And this forsaken city. Your time's run out. Underestimate the true children of Arkham. These souls kept behind bars. Open the doors! Arkham! Listen to me! Freedom is yours! The only one standing in your way is Batman.
Batman.
He stuck me in here!
Me too. Let me at him.
He's the crazy one.
Thank you. truly inspiring. Such a pleasure to see your work in person.
Batman!
Lady Arkham has a hostage.
We've got the inmates. Lock it down!
There's no way out now.
There's always another way here, Batman. All the people that Thomas Wayne condemned to this place unwillingly, they speak through the walls. Their ghosts walk. They know the way.
I can't help those people now, but I can help Alfred Pennyworth. Take me to him.
My pleasure.
Vicky! Vicky! Show yourself! Let him go!
The butler has to die. Payment for Thomas Wayne's sins. He took away my family. So I'll take away his sons. If you really want to save the butler, bring me Bruce Wayne. If anyone can find him, it's you. He's probably cowering behind a 12-inch thick wall and 100 bodyguards right now.
I'll bring you Wayne. But first, let Alfred Pennyworth go.
No. Afraid he's too useful to do that just yet. You're doing so much for one old man.
Vicky, stop playing games.
This isn't a game to me. You know, Batman, I really don't understand. Why are you fighting me? I've done great things for Gotham. Falcone and Hill deserved to die. If anything, I did you a favor. We're fighting the same fight, Batman. Can't you see that? We want the same things.
Those men deserved their day in court, just like everyone else.
So they could have gotten off like they did so many times before? No, Batman. They got exactly what they deserved. My justice is final and absolute. You shouldn't be here. You shouldn't be defending him. You think Bruce Wayne is any better than his father? He hides behind his status and wealth. He's a coward, blaming other men. I'm curious, Batman. I know why I wear the mask. It's who I am, who I was always meant to be. What about you? Do you wear the mask to hide? Or to become who you really are? Are you the man? Or the mask?
The mask is a symbol. Some fear it. But for others, it brings hope.
When I first saw it, I found it inspiring. And once you're dead, I'm going to mount that mask on my wall. But first... See the man beneath.
Hold on, Alfred.
You came. You came for me. After what you said, I knew you'd come. The man I made you.
Just hold on, Alfred. Did you see where she went?
She just disappeared.
I'm getting you out of here.
Above you!
Interesting how you speak to him. So familiar. Alfred. Such concern for someone you've never met before.
It's called compassion, Vicky. Something you seem to know very little about.
Sounds like deflection to me. There's more here than you're telling. It makes me wonder, do you really care? Only one way to find out. Oh.
Batman, don't you...
Shut up, old man! You've seen my true self. Your turn. Prove that you can. Take off your mask. Let me see the man you really are.
If that's what it will take to save him.
No!
Must be some kind of trick. Bruce Wayne, he'd never be the man Batman is. He only looks out for himself. Oh, but of course. Now I understand. As Batman, you can prey upon the weak, the defenseless, just like your father did. A true Wayne. There's nothing heroic about you.
I can't change what happened in the past. I would have fought for you, Vicky. No one should have to suffer the way that you did.
You don't know how I suffered. But you will. I'll show you what Thomas Wayne did to me. To my family.
I'll bury you! stop, Vicky. It's over.
Nothing will keep me from my revenge.
As to last week's events at Arkham Asylum, a spokesperson for the GCPD assured us that the breakout has been contained and all inmates have been returned to their cells. Miss Vale is missing and presumed dead following a gruesome battle with the caped vigilante known only as the Batman. Her death marks the end of Children of Arkham's Reign of Terror.
If the public knew the half of it...
It's better that they don't.
This came in the mail. It's unsigned.
Selina.
With everything that's been going on, I haven't gotten a chance to thank you for what you did, sacrificing your identity for my safety. But it was a dangerous thing to do. You could lose everything. The secrecy you've worked so hard to maintain, gone.
Without you, none of this would work. You are my family.
You don't know how good it is to hear you say that, after everything that's happened. And your ear? At least there's something left of it.
Dr. Tompkins assured me it adds character.
That it does. We will get through this, Bruce.
Don't lose sight of the fact that you've done some real good for Gotham. You should be proud.
Lady Arkham, Penguin, Harvey. They won't be the last to threaten Gotham.
Likely not, but you'll be ready. In the meantime, let us hope for some peace. To peace.
The damage done by the Children of Arkham has left Gotham a city in turmoil. Faith in those at the top has perhaps irrevocably been shaken. Acting Commissioner James Gordon has promised to speak out about the issue tonight during an emergency citywide address.
And I hope, despite the recent terror that's gripped our city, that Gotham's leading citizens will come out to show their support.
Will his token appointment be enough to regain the city's trust? It remains to be seen. But experts agree that...
Gordon requested Gotham's leaders to stand behind him. Leaders like you. Let Gotham see who Bruce Wayne truly is, and let them know what you plan to do for his future.
Well, this could be a fresh start.
For you, and for this city. Though, in Gotham, the only figure that can make as much impact as a Wayne...
is Batman.
You've helped this city tremendously, both as Bruce Wayne and Batman. And that person, whether he dons a cape or not, is someone I'm proud of and honored to call my friend.
Thank you, Alfred.
So, what do you intend to do about tonight?
Well, Lucius has yet to invent a suit that'll let Bruce Wayne and Batman be in the same place at once.
That is unfortunate. I suppose you must decide whose appearance will be more valuable. As Bruce, you can help repair the damage done to your name, get the public support so that you can change things from the top down. But Batman is a symbol of justice and strength. Maybe in these dark times, that is truly what Gotham needs the most. Perhaps one is truly the mask, and one is who you truly believe you are.
Batman will be in attendance.
You'll make quite the impression. Gordon will be grateful.
We're currently awaiting newly appointed Acting Police Commissioner James Gordon, who will address the city for the first time in the wake of the terrorist attacks perpetrated by Lady Arkham.
I, as Acting Police Commissioner... Commissioner Gordon. It doesn't sound right. Batman! Is everything all right? I assume you're not here to give a speech. So, what is it?
It's an important day. Your first address to the city as acting commissioner. I wanted you to know that I stand with you. I want Gotham to know that there are those who will fight for them.
Oh, I'm glad you feel that way. City's on edge. Tonight can make all the difference. You're one hell of an addition to this lineup. Gotham's best and brightest have turned out for this. I know you're not a man of many words, but I'd like to say something to Gotham on your behalf. Is there anything you'd like them to know? Maybe about how you'd like to be seen moving forward? Had a feeling you'd say that. You know, I always wanted this. To be commissioner someday. To have the chance to shape this. I should probably be used to that by now. Now, in the last few weeks, as much violence and terror as I've seen, I've also seen the citizens of this community band together to fight those threats. One of those citizens is Batman. I asked him to speak here tonight, but he's a man of action, not words. We need men and women like that. Heroes who will fight to lift Gotham out of the darkness, rather than simply talking about making a difference. Let Gotham be a city of heroes. United, strong, and hopeful. Bastard to lock up.
Just minutes ago, Acting Commissioner James Gordon delivered a rousing speech that turned into a shocking assassination attempt on his life. Batman made short work of the assassin.
Oh boy, it's gonna be tough to top that.
But I'll give it a shot.
Ha 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 ha!